minus 3.8 volt. The signal is varying. Minus 3.8, plus 3.8. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In last session, I created plus minus 3.7 volt signal using two 3.7 volt batteries, and I connected one USB module TP4056 to charge these batteries. If you have not watched that video, the video number is displayed on the screen. You can watch that video. When this switch is in this side, it will charge the batteries in parallel. When we will shift this switch to second side, at that time this switch will create series connection, and we will take plus 3.7 common and minus 3.7. Today we will take a dual polarity signal. We will create stimuli to test MOSFETs and other components, and we will inject that signal in upcoming videos to different circuits, and we will make a variable signal from minus 3.7 to plus 3.7. From this plus minus 3.7, A, B, C, we will follow these three points, A, B, C. A, B, C. We will connect 15 ohm resistor in both lines, positive and negative. This is common, plus 3.7, minus 3.7. It will work as a fuse resistor. This is common. I will take single pole, single throw switch. If I will change this switch to this side, that time minus 3.7 volt signal will here. If switch is in this side, that time plus 3.7 volt signal is here, and this is common point. This point here, this point here, and I will use double pole double throw switch, 6-point switch. We can use double pole single throw or double pole double throw. This switch I have, so I will use 4 points, and I will connect this signal to a potentiometer, 5k potentiometer. I will take variable signal. Let's connect it. So in this way, we will able to take dual polarity stimuli signal and variable stimuli signal from minus 3.7 to plus 3.7. this switch in this side. So I will take negative out from this side. So negative must be connected here. We will take output from center point. And left side pin will be connected to positive. So when we will move this switch here, positive will come out from this switch. Whenever this prototype combination will ready, then I will install it any box. This is coming out. Now I will install this switch here. We will turn on this switch when we want to operate this potentiometer. Otherwise, this switch will remain off so that the potentiometer will not discharge the batteries all the time. Okay, it is 5K. I will use both sections to make it 2.5K. Yes, now it is 2.5K. Output minus 3.7 volt here, center pin output, right side positive 3.7 volts. This potentiometer will receive voltage when we will turn on this switch in this direction, closer to potentiometer. If this switch is in off position, that time this potentiometer will remain out of circuit. The slider output will reach to this winding post. Now this positive here at this point and negative 3.7 here. If you are interested to make it, you can design in good shape, because I am just demonstrating it. So that is reason I am making everything visible. Now our stimuli circuit is ready. DC voltage. I will use banana connectors to take signal out. I will connect wires. Common. Minus 3.8. Plus 3.8. This is dual polarity signal. From the same point we will take plus 3.8 volt. We will just change this switch. We will receive minus 3.8 volt. So this signal will be used to test N-channel MOSFETs, P-channel MOSFETs, NPN transistors, PNP transistors, IGBTs. Common signal out. Turn on this switch. Minus 3.8 volt. The signal is varying. This signal, dual polarity signal, will be used to test components in saturation mode. And for testing linear conduction mode, we will use this signal. I hope this video is informative for you. If it is good, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.